Alright, so what's up you guys, it's your boy Doncho, and for today's video I want to talk about the latest event that has found its way onto your home screen in Granblue Fantasy, and that event will be none other than Proving Grounds. I figured it would be a good time for me to help out the newer to intermediate players with a guide on what this game mode is all about. I'll explain how the game mode works and what you can expect from it as a beginner, in order to make it easier to understand for those who haven't participated in a Proving Grounds before. Now just before we dig into this video, I just wanted to say that if you do enjoy Granblue Fantasy or Granblue Fantasy Versus content, then you might want to consider hitting that sub button, as I do cover both games and try to keep you guys updated with everything as fast as possible surrounding these games and more. Now with all the typical YouTuber talk out the way, let's get into the video. So first things first, how does Proving Grounds even work? Proving Grounds is a limited time event where you get to participate in sets of multiple battles, which is called a sortie. In a sortie, you will have to face enemies in one wave as you go, but to keep things interesting in this game mode, you will have to use multiple parties to clear a run, which means that you can't rely on a single party to run through the event. This would directly be the main catch of the event itself, and makes Proving Grounds stand out compared to the other events in game. With parties being the main focus of the event, it's of course useful to know what element the enemies will be, and in case you aren't aware yet, this time it will be dark. Each run of the event has a different element that it focuses on, meaning that it rotates in elements every time the event comes back to the game. But truth to be told, Proving Grounds itself is somewhat geared towards a bit more advanced players, as it does ask you to build multiple teams for a single element. And this can be hard to do if you are a fresh player that recently started playing, but luckily the significant rewards that you would want to aim for in this event are relatively easy to get, even for the newer players. So now that we know the gist of the event itself, it's time to get a little bit more in depth with the event mechanics and how it all works. So let's get you guys prepared for the event. And to start things off, I will have to pull back on the topics of the battles that you will be fighting during this event, which in this case will be called a sortie. These sorties consist out of a string of battles, and will require you as a player to form multiple parties to take on the enemies that you will face as you go. So it's safe to say that forming parties is key to this event, and now that we are aware of that fact, we can start talking more about the party building aspect altogether, which can be done in two different ways. The first way would be to manually select your parties together, which you are most likely already used to by playing the game naturally. But the second method might be a bit easier, as it is an auto-select option. By using the auto-select option, the game will automatically fill in your parties, which you can then use right away. Personally, I do recommend building your parties manually, as the auto-select function does make some odd choices at times, which can be avoided if you set your parties up manually. But with auto-selection aside, we can start talking about the party building restrictions, as there are a few rules that you will need to follow when building your teams to take on this event. For example, your parties are allowed to share weapon grids and summons across the board, and your main character may also use the same class and skills across all parties, but other versions of characters can only be included in one party per sortie. It's also good to note that no changes can be made to any party that has won a battle already until the sortie is either cleared or cancelled. Proving Grounds also has a unique mechanic to its event to help you with taking on the battles, as it makes it slightly easier on the player side of things, and that mechanic will be boosted characters. Each run of the event has a group of characters that will get a boosted effect during the event period, and you can tell who these characters are by the P icon that will be right besides them when you are making your party. The boosted character information always gets shared at the launch of the event, so make sure to read the slides whenever the event comes around. And you might be thinking, what about our support summons? Now, as far as summons go, luckily we are allowed to use support summons during our sortie runs, and your support summon will be available to be selected at the start of every sortie that you begin, just like any other regular raid. The summon that you have chosen will be used throughout the whole sortie, so make sure to keep that in mind when picking. Then at last, regarding parties, I want to briefly talk about party statuses, as this does play a role into the event to a certain extent. If you select a party that has been used in a previous battle, the character status such as HP, buffs, debuffs, or skill cooldowns and status effects will not be reset. On the other hand, summon aura effects, support skill effects, weapon skill effects that change based on turns passed, and field effects will in fact be reset. This makes using your previous party optional, and a situation may arise that you would like to make use of this. But before you do, make sure to weigh out the advantages and disadvantages for using your previous parties, and from there on out decide the best decision for the situation at hand. Now with the basics of the party making process discussed, we can start taking a look into gameplay of the event itself, as we will talk about how it all works from the gameplay's perspective. So let's talk about the battles that you will have to take on during this event. As I have mentioned before in this video, the battles that you will be fighting will be in form of a sortie. Generally, a sortie exists out of two battles, but this can also be exceeded at a higher difficulty to a total of 3 battles instead. Every sortie that you will take on can only be cleared by winning all of its battles along the way. And whilst the rules about characters from your first party not being able to be included into the second party will always remain, there is a specific case where this slightly gets altered, as certain sorties are longer than 2 battles, and if they are longer than 2 battles, you will be allowed to use a party from a previous fight once more to take on the third battle. And whilst we are still on topic about the fights that will take place in this event, we will follow up on the topic by talking about the sorties difficulties that will be available for you to try out. Each difficulty can be unlocked by clearing the previous difficulty, and as the difficulties of the sorties will rise, there will be more battles to be played as well during each sortie. For the difficulties Very Hard, Extreme, Extreme Plus, and Maniac, you will have to take on a total of 2 battles, whilst Proud and Proud Plus will have you take on a total of 3 battles per sortie instead. The Maniac sortie can only be cleared once a day, and the Proud and Proud Plus sorties will only provide completion rewards once during the event period as a whole. You won't be able to use elixirs during your Proud and Proud Plus sorties, and whilst most people watching won't have to be concerned about Proud fights, I do want to mention that the power of the enemies in Proud and Proud Plus sorties will be significantly greater than any other difficulties before that. The Proud Plus sortie especially will be the most challenging content amongst all of the event quests in the game, and this sortie will most likely not get cleared until you have a well thought out battle strategy and party formation to take on the fight and make it all come together. Enemies that appear in extreme and harder difficulty sorties will have resistance to all elements except for the element that has advantage over the event as a whole. All the other elements outside of the advantage one will deal significantly less damage than normal, so it's important to make sure you're using the right element parties to tackle the event. Now your Maniac, Proud and Proud Plus sorties can be retried until you have cleared them, and will allow you to retry the sortie even if you have cancelled them before. This allows you to try and come up with all sorts of tactics and teams as you challenge yourself to take on the difficulty that will be pushing your limits, so make sure to have fun with it whilst you can. Chances are, whilst you're experimenting with different strategies to take on the highest difficulty that you can try, that you will have to retry the sortie by quite a few times. This will bring me to the next two topics, which will all fall under the category of attempts. First up, we have retrying, and as for retrying, you can retry each battle if the entire party is knocked out or if you decide to retreat from a battle. If you end up retreating or getting knocked out, your party will be reset to its state before having entered the battle itself. Your characters, your weapons, your summons, and the main character's class and skills can be changed whilst you are retrying, but that also means that all your damage, your buffs, and debuffs on the enemy as well as your allies will be reset too. Then we have the last resort option, which will be straight up ending the sortie, and this can be done by pressing the evacuate button on the event page itself. Your battle progress in the sortie will be reset, and the sortie can be started over from the very first battle. The AP that you've used to start a sortie won't be returned if the sortie is evacuated, so keep that in mind if that is important to you. With retrying and evacuations discussed, we have arrived at the last topic of today's video, which will be the loot system and its prizes that will be offered during the event. And as for event loot, each run of Proving Grounds will have a weapon that will be available to get as you play the event. These weapons are definitely recommended to go for, as Proving Grounds is an event that doesn't have a very strict schedule on returning, so it's best to get them whilst you can. You will also be able to obtain loot from each battle of a sortie, and in addition to this, if you clear all your battles, you will get rewarded with even more loot as a completion reward, which of course is always nice to get. Aside from the loot that you will obtain from each sortie, you will also notice that you are able to pick up items by gathering battle badges. The battle badge loot includes the event exclusive weapon, a gold spell book, and an SSR draw ticket, to name a few specifics. Make sure to get the most out of the event run by planning out the rewards accordingly, so you won't have any regrets on leaving certain rewards because you didn't plan it out correctly. You will also notice that during your playthrough, you will start accumulating points, and these points will be called Proving Ground points. These Proving Ground points can be obtained by satisfying certain requirements during your sortie battles, and the points themselves will allow you to get your hands on some rewards as you continue to stack up points during the event as you go. The requirement for obtaining these points in significant numbers fall into a total of 3 categories. The first category will be damage, which is calculated by the amount of damage that is dealt to the enemies. Then you have action bonuses, which is calculated by the use of skills, summon calls, and activated chambers, and everything of the like. And at last, the results. By clearing a battle under certain conditions, such as having all 6 characters remaining, clearing a battle within 10 turns, or even even including SR or R characters into your party, you can start obtaining more points as well. Do note that there is a limit to PG points that can be earned in a single battle, so you won't have to go out your way to gain these once you have hit your cap. And on that note, we have come at the end of today's Proving Grounds guide. Hopefully you guys will find the information I gave today helpful and made you able to learn something new about the game. If you guys do feel like you want more beginner content like my guides in general, then I'll gladly make other videos with some more tips and tricks for beginners and so on. So let me know in the comments down below if that is of any interest. Now if you guys want more help from me directly or just feel like joining a place where you can meet more Grumble Fantasy players to talk about the game and have fun, then I do recommend joining my Discord, which I'll provide the link for down below in the pinned comment. And that was it for today guys, it was your boy Duncho, stay healthy, stay blessed, and I'm out. Peace.